arithmetic progressions. Let us see some of the patterns here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and so on. These are the sum of the patterns we will observe. And 1, 4, 9, 25 and so on. We can observe in this patterns, we'll observe some of the rule in this. Here, the difference between the two numbers is 1, and difference between these two numbers is 1, and difference between these two numbers is 1. It's following some of the rule in these numbers. This is called as sequence. These numbers are following some of the order, some of the rule in this particular rule. This rule is called sequence. This total is called sequence. And if you see here, in the second one, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, in these numbers, the difference between these two numbers is 2 and 2 and 2. Here also 2. So here we can observe, the difference between the two numbers is 2. This is also following the sum of the rule. 8 is also a sequence. Third one, we'll see the third pattern. In this, 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, 16 and 25. This is 4 square and 5 square and so on. We can observe these are the squares of natural numbers. So this pattern is also following some of the rule in this. It is also called a sequence. So here in this sequence we take the first value 1, 4, 9, 6, 25 and so on in this. First term, if you take this first term called as A, also A1. The first term is called as A1 or A. The second term is called as A2. The third term is called as is A3. And so on. And finally here, what we get the term is called as, the last term is called as, suppose this is nth term, then we call the term as an. So let us recall again, here these are the some of the patterns. In these patterns we will observe some of the rule in these numbers. That rule is called as a sequence. In this sequence we will see the difference between the numbers is same, and some of the difference between the numbers is same here. These are following the square numbers. Here 1 square, 2 square, 3 square and 4 square and 5 square. These are the square numbers. And here the first, these are these sequences. In these sequences the first term is called A1, second term is called A2, third term is called A3 and so on. Finally what we get the term in nth place, the term is called as nth term. So here first term is A1 or A, second term A2, third term A3, fourth term A4 and fifth term A5 and so on. What we get term, that is An, nth term. If this is the nth term, then we call the term as An. So first term A, also A1 we call, that is 2 here. We can observe, it is following some of the rule.
The difference between these two numbers is 2, and the difference between these two numbers is 2. So this is called as a sequence. This sequence, in this sequence, first term is A1 is 2, second term A2 is 4, third term A3 is 6, fourth term A4 is 8, fifth term A5 is 10. In this, we can observe, we want to get the first term is A1, same as it is. We want to get the second term, A2 is equals to A1 plus a constant number is added to this. That is, the difference between these two numbers is 2. The difference between these two numbers is 2 and also 2. Here also 2. So a constant number is added to that number is 2. So A1 here, A1 is equals to 2, and then A2 is equals to A1 plus 2, previous number, and a 2 is added to the A1 previous number, and a constant number is added to that. That is, A1 is equals to, we know that A1 is 2, and a constant number is added to that number is 2. 2 plus 2 is 4. Second term, here the second term is 4. We are getting the second term here. So to get third term, A3, here, second term, we'll take the previous term, that is A2, and we have added a constant number. The difference between these two numbers is 2. So we add a constant number to this, A2 plus 2. A2 is nothing but 4. 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. Again, A4 is equals to, the previous number is A3. A3 plus 2 is equals to 6 plus 2, that is nothing but 8. And A5 is equals to A4 plus 2, and 8 plus 2 is equals to 10. Here we can observe some of the rule, and to get the next term, we are adding a constant number, that is 2 here for each and every number. And to get next number, the previous term is added to a constant number. To get the next term, here also same thing, A4 is equals to A3 plus 2, A5 is equals to A4 plus 2, and that is 10. So these sequences are called as arithmetic progressions. The sequences which follow the particular rule in this, the sequences, all the sequences, are called as arithmetic progressions. 2, 4, 6, 8 is a sequence, and it will follow a particular rule between these numbers, that is difference between these two, and this rule, this is called as progression, arithmetic progression. In this first term, and also these all the numbers, and if we observe here, first term A1, A2, A3 and so on, An, we already discussed about it. To get the next number, first number is 2, we already discussed about it, and the second number, to get the second number, next term, we added a constant number. We'll call that constant number as difference or common difference. Common difference D, we'll add a particular number to it. That number we are calling as D, a common difference is D. So to get the next number, A2, previous number is A1 plus D. So A1 plus D is nothing but 2 plus 2, 4. Here we can observe, A1 is first term, A1 is equals to first term, and common difference is D. And then A2 is equals to A1 plus common difference, and A3 is equals to A2 plus common difference, and A4 is equals to A3 plus D, A5 is equals to A4 plus D, and so on. We can observe here, to find the nth term, we are taking the previous term, that is
nth term minus 1 previous term of it plus d. To find out nth term, here we can observe from this first term is a common difference is d. To get second term, we are adding previous term to the constant, to the common difference. Similarly here, to get nth term, the previous term of it and common difference we added. So an is equal to an minus 1 plus d.